Welcome back to Log Rocket. I'm going to be showing you the secret of creating a stunning mobile apps mockup in Figma. I'm going to be recreating this. I'm just going to be very, very fast. To recreate this, we're just going to duplicate this screen. I'm going to take off this, and also take this off. Then we'll leave our status bar. So to go move further, this header, just going to come here, select an eclipse, then drop it, press K on my laptop, resize it. So just come here and I'm going to write search. Then once the search is there, I'm just going to set this to 14. You just have to maintain visual hierarchy, right? So the thing that I'm going to do now is to set this to regular, then pick this icon. If you want to get an icon, just use feather icon. So to do this, I'm going to set this out, get this off, select these two and add auto layout. So once these two is on auto layout, make sure that the gap between them is just 10. I'm just going to give another 10 on top, then I'm going to give another 16. Then now I'm going to allow it to float on the left. What I'm going to do now is to, this is already pre-built colors that I've used. So let's check the colors that is here. So the color that is here is gray 150 as the background and gray 100. That is how that was created. I'm going to set this to leave it at 150, then set the background to this gray 100, this, then set the corner radius to 50. That is how I got this. So this one is 70, doesn't really matter. The pattern left and right to 16 and 10. So the same thing we have here. So we just set this to search, and we can now leave this like this. Make sure that this is set like this, and we're going to pick these two icons. Just take these two icons and set it here. Then select everything here and add auto layout. So to balance this, I'm going to set this to fill, right? So the padding here, I'm going to set it to 16. So once we do that, move this right inside here. It's not going to enter because it's pretty much on auto layout. So I'm just going to come here and remove auto layout. So push it inside here. Push it inside its frame. Now if you set this like this and also set this, make sure this is up, get this up here, set this here, then we're going to make sure that 16 is the padding on both ends, so we can actually move the entire stuff here into this place. So we just duplicate it and move this here. What I actually did here was recreate this card. This is an image. To recreate this, you just write the phone number. But we want to just make the balance you have more important. So you just have to emphasize on what you want the users to see first on this page. So just have to make it very bold. And this is on 32. And we actually make this 14. So here is the account number. This will not pass the accessibility test. So what I'm going to do now is detach this and actually brighten it up a bit. Right, so here are some of the things that actually makes you come up with great stunning mockups in Figma. So here is some of the things that the card couldn't contain. Once they click here, they will see the menu, and this is just literally the card though. So here we try as much as we can to bring in the amount spent, the cashbacks, your cycles, and the history. If you want to create the footer, I'm just going to copy this. I'm going to show you how this footer was made, so you'll be able to create a stunning footer. So bring this out, bring this out, bring this out, bring this out, and bring this out. Take this, select this, bring it here. I'm going to delete this. So now to bring this out, I'm going to select all of this and add auto layout. That is how this was created. Because the width is 430, I'm going to set this to 430. Now set this to automatic. What we are going to do now is to set a pattern of 16, and we're going to open this up. For the top, we're going to use 10, then for the bottom, we're going to use 20. So the reason why we're using 20 is because of this home button. So I'm going to now set the color to this color. And once that is done, we are going to make sure that there's enough space below and not on the top. This is not going to be on the center. We're going to set it to top. We are also going to set this to 20. Then take this home icon and bring it here. Once it's here, it's gonna mess things up. The only thing you need to do is just to set this to absolute, bring it down and set it to the center. We're going to bring it up a bit. The next thing we're going to do is to make sure that this is actually on 24. So if you bring it in here, I'm just going to press Ctrl Z, copy it and select this and paste it. So once you paste it, set it on the center and take it to the bottom. Now we're going to set the color to pure black because this is pure black. Remember, the background color on this gray stuff is dark gray, kind of. So that was how I actually created this. So this is just to create a disparity. To create this ones, it's just creating circles, add another layout, create your circle and this CO, and add this on auto layout, add this also on auto layout, and group everything together. So I'm just going to quickly do the wireframe. Select this, it's very easy. Select this and I'm going to reduce it. Let's check the size. So the size is 48. So we're going to set this. To get this, we're going to select 48. So the width and the height will also be affected on the sizing. Once you do that, we're going to duplicate this, duplicate and duplicate and duplicate. So select all of them. We have a plus icon here to bring out the plus icon. I'm going to bring it out and add auto layouts. Before you add auto layout to some of these icons, you need to frame them first. So I'm going to frame it, then add auto layout. To get it to be on the same width and the height of this, I'm just going to click this and set this to 48. So now make sure that this is on the center, select and add this, then we're going to make this 60. That way everything is on the same line. The last thing I'm going to do now is to show you how I actually added this. I'm just going to bring this out. So what I actually did was to go to feather icon, then brought this out, just click on it. Iconify would allow you drag it, then this would also allow you to click on it for it to come out. So just click on this and reduce this to 16. So once it's on 16, make sure you're placing it somewhere around here. Remember what I told you, frame this first, because if you add auto layout, it's going to mess up your work. So I'm now going to add auto layouts, then add 5 here and add 5 here. Once that is done, you see this is actually going to be big, so we're just trying to do the green one. So I'm going to set this to green and the black I'm going to change it to white. Give this a full color radius of 50, and once we have this, remember it's now on 26. So I'm going to click on this again and reduce this to 12. This is not actually reducing, so we're going to reduce this to 12. I'm going to reduce it to 8, then get this, just make it 10, then get this to be 14. 14 doesn't give us what we want. We're going to get this down a bit to 8. Yeah, so it makes sense, so we'll leave it at 8. If you want to reduce the vector, you just come here and click on 1. And once that is done, what we need to do is to make this a frame, because this should be frame. So what we're going to do is just to add auto layout on this. Now we're going to remove this to be 0, 0, and 0. So this doesn't come in. This doesn't come in. What I'm going to do now is to take this inside here and make it absolute. Push it here and we're going to now bring it here. So we can now have lots of feet. We're going to delete this one and duplicate this one, duplicate this, duplicate and duplicate. So we're going to select all of them and add auto layout. If you want to reduce, you just drag this and reduce it and give it the definite pattern you want. That is how all of this was created. And if you want to create a very good mockup. Make sure you are mindful of your colors, you're mindful of your icons, you're mindful of your text sizes, you're mindful of the images that you use. All these things will help you come up with great Figma mockups. You're also mindful of how you use strokes, the padding, the spacing. All these things adds up to make you a great mockup in Figma. And I hope to see you on our next video. Bye for now.